Turn it off. Gotta turn off the music before Facebook be like, banned. Right. Besides, that song comes on way too dang much. If you love me, just say so. Ooh, baby. Cause I don't wonder. Wait, what's the rest of the song? Yeah. If you love me, babe. Cause I don't. Oh yeah, I can't play these games with you no more. That dang old song comes on all the time. But yet, I still can't remember the words. Yeah, I don't pay attention to it. Ah, what's up, people? Catch you, Ryan. What's going on? Sunday. Wait, oh, my bad. Saturday. Saturday. Hold up. All right. Let me head on out of here. I'm about to find something to eat amongst this coronavirus, people. Scared people. All right. You know, I really want to go get me some. I would love to go get me my mushroom garlic soup I get at this local Chinese spot. But I can't do that because they closed all the Chinese spots because of the dumb folks, right? But yeah, I was making this video real quick. I wanted to talk about, learning a lot about astrology, right? I'm trying to get that down packed. I want to get me eventually my astrology mat so I can sit behind and make videos, have some type of background. Nah, people on YouTube do it. They have some type of background. I don't have no fancy green screen, so I won't be able to do that, what I would love to do. Man, this is one spot I went to, an Indian cuisine, and it was good. Now they closed because of coronavirus. We don't want to spray it, shit. So we gotta close our doors. All these places that I like to go eat, we gotta close their doors. Because it's quote-unquote not essential. I think good cooking, it's essential, but you know, I think this Mexican restaurant's open down here. Let me check. Are they open? I would hate the driveway. It's a because it's a good little distance, it's not too far though. All right, let me see. All right, cool. So, let's talk about this book right here. I was reading this book, Astrology Black Bible. Really getting to breaking down what my ascendant and descendants and what that means just in particular for anybody. And ascending, descending. And I was like, thinking about, well, what could that mean as far as science goes? And then I put it into perspective, like, oh, that makes sense now. Think of your descending signs as stuff that you already conquered. So think of it as your chakra symbols, chakras, where your lower nature chakras below your heart chakra is what you already conquered. So it's already part of you. You know, so those things that's below you are already part of you. That's inside of your, this part of your DNA, you know. And everything up here is what you're trying to achieve or trying to conquer over. And once you conquer over that, you can put it down here below your belly because you conquered it already. So that's how you can think of your ascending and descending signs. I was like, okay, that makes sense. I was thinking to myself while I'm studying. I'm like, okay, that makes sense. So, and then you got your fixed symbol and then your negative symbols. And then, you know, basically water signs, earth signs is negative. It's more the feminine power. then your air and your fire is more your masculine power, which is, you know, I'm a fire sign, I'm a Sagittarius. The Sagittarius is you know, basically associated to Jupiter, but, you know, the ruler sign of Sagittarius is the Aries, right? So, then again, you know, I was looking at my sign for my chart. I was like, what is my dominant chart sign? So, apparently, I was looking through it, and it said Sagittarius. Well, I'm a Sagittarius, but it was saying that Aries is my ascendant sign. I'm like, oh. But then again, you know, as I thought about that, I like, you know, I always had this thing for Venus. You know, protecting Venus, being her protector. And at one point of time, before Mars got taken over and destroyed into a wasteland, Mars was a vast jungle, also a vast, beautiful place. You know, every place had their nice, vast, lush land. You know, nothing but just a desert, just to be a desert, because that's not what our DNA beings was about. We were not about that lush. No, different species may like that deserty place. So that's why it became into a desert-like place, because these species from other places that likes that type of style wanted to come and screw up what we had over here, right? So yeah, Venus was, of course, the Amazon, the place of the woman. And then, you know, Earth was like the baby. And we was protecting Earth. Earth was like a new thought form. Was something that was thinking about what to do with Earth. What can Earth become? What can Earth be? And that was Earth and Mars, basically. Venus and Mars, basically, that was their child, you know, in a way, if you want to put it like that. Man for Mars, women are for Venus. That's what it says, right? But then again, you know, of course, you got the mixtures of energies. So yeah, of course, you know, we say that, but then, you know, it got the mixtures of energy. So, you know, an Amazonian warrior mixed up can, you know, if they wanted to, can achieve a man from Mars energy. But Venus energy, you know, the whole thing before they got tempered with, before those beings that came down and try to take her power away. Once Mars got diluted and became too masculine and fiery within its own self, and start to get destroyed by weapons of war. Because the first there was another planet, which is, you know, behind, that was behind Mars, which you may have heard about. And that got destroyed by a super weapon because of the mass fighting. Then Mars got affected. After Mars, then Venus. Then all these places, then, you know, slowly but surely, that tried to trigger into Earth. So you got all these beings inside these bodies, these flesh meats, right, mixed in. Within the body. That's why Man in Black is so powerful, because, you know, you're basically looking at, that's what you're looking at. You're looking at different species inside of flesh suits, right? We all for different parts of the universe. But yeah. But that good old story, you might have heard it before. I'm about to see if this place is open, because I really want to sit down and eat. Hopefully they'll let you eat inside, right? Be like, no, you can't come in here. I don't think they'll care, though. Hopefully they're open, though. I drove down here. Alright. Oh, yeah, the fireworks. I don't think they're going to be open because it's not essential. Well, I bet. Actually, you know what? Fireworks may be open. They may say that's essential because it's patriotic. Yeah. But in but yeah, in this book, I had to cover my yawn. So yes, in this book, I love this thing, by the way. Shout outs. I gotta give me some more of these. Or guns. Yeah, so then, you know, of course, each planet or plan for ETs have their own pyramids, and these pyramids have all gun energy too, right? Or what you want to call it, basically energy where we can telepathically connect to one another, to visit one another, basically. But we all now on different frequencies, got knocked off orbit off of different frequencies. Everything got knocked out of orbit. Earth got knocked out of orbit. That's why its frequency changed. So that's why when you look at these other stars, they look quite different. Earth got knocked out of frequency. North. What is it? North or South Pole? One of those two used to be a lush land. Then somehow, Sahara Desert used to be a lush land, but then that got turned into a desert wasteland. Which Sahara Desert was, of course, one of the first places. Well, you might have heard that story about Marduk, and not Marduk, but Enlil and Unki. That was one of the first places that got hit by a super weapon. Luckily, it did not destroy the Earth too much, but it did knock her off the orbit. But the second sun, third sun, is going to be showing back up. People always talk about, prophesizing, talking about they seeing a blue star, blue sun in the sky. You know, we'll be seeing it pretty soon. Be popping back up. But yeah, I just looking into studying a little bit more into this astrology thing. I want to really get deep into it, learning. I want to actually I look at this bird like, bird, get your bread. You know where you flop the bread at now. Look at you. Get your bread. If you don't get that bread, pick it up and fly off. That bird right there. By the way, I've been talking about crows. Someone said they mentioned about seeing crows and stuff. I'm like, okay. You know what that means. Crows and ravens get confused a lot also. So that's why I like to make sure. Are you talking about crow or raven? Because they can get confused. Alright, let's see this place open. I know I'm talking all around places, talking back and forth about different things. Oh, I think they're open. Let's see. I better get me some Mexican food. Are they open? To go orders only. Well, they're open, but I can't sit inside. Alright, cool. That's all I need to know. I just need to order some food. That's all I want. I just want me some nice grilled cactus leaves, some beans, some nice rice, fried rice. Yes, sir. That's about to go in there right now and get. And of course, everyone's sitting inside their car. Let me go ahead and order my food. But yeah. So real quick. But yeah, this is what I was looking at. And it showed energy flow, how energy flows. And of course, you got all this symbolism going on, how the energy bounce around. Boing, boing. It goes right here. Then it can come like that. Then it can go back here. You can go back up here. Then you go, you know, energy flow. You know, got all these different ways how energy can flow. never stopping. That's why I say energy never stops. It always moves. Energy never stops. And I'm an Aquarius moon, so it's fixed, and it's a plus sign. And they said this, you know, which is pretty cool, because Aquarius moon fixed houses are the 2nd, 5th, 8th, and 11th gates. And, you know, and it tells you all this stuff in here about fixed signs. If you're Aquarius, fixed sign, it tells you that in here, what it's about. A mutual sign. You got Sagittarius. Sagittarius is also, yep. Basically says I am a mutual quality into an exploration of life endless possibilities. I'm very restless because I'm always looking to seek knowledge, you know. Yup. They even got Chiron in here, right? Chiron. They even got that up in here. Which they don't even consider that even a planet. They just consider this a big old rock, right? But I am North Node. I am the North Node, the life path. And it's in my 7th house, which is, that's why I have my life path number 7, which is, this is why this is so much important to me, because I'm on the path of evolution. So this is pretty cool. And I am a Sagittarius, so the path of the seeker. The soul is on the quest for knowledge of the true meaning behind the universe and physical incarnation. But my North Node is in the Libra house. So the path of relationship. The soul is learning how to be an equal partner in relationship so that the needs of each party are taken care of. So that's pretty cool, because then it also, you know, it kind of talks to me about, hey, you know, I am in that whole process. You know, I always look out for my people, make sure they're taken care of. And as far as relationship goes, you know, I want to be that person that watches out and make sure that you're seeking knowledge and you're taken care of. Right? So, this is like an adventure video. Coming into the store, going to El Rodeo. Asada, real steak, cactus, yep.
cool, cool.
I should get some sun. Alright, so. Yeah, so I ordered me some cactus beans, rice, and some leeks. I love my little leeks, my leeks. If you don't know what leeks are, just think about Mario 2, Super Mario World 2, back in the day. The little leeks come out the ground, you pick up a leek, throw it at the little ninjas. They bounce off their head, they fall over. Yeah, that's funny, right? Yeah, I'm glad they're open. Shoot, at least, yeah, it was a nice, how far the draft this was? About like a 10-minute drive. Not far. No one's outside, that's why it took 10 minutes. It would took forever if it wasn't. Yeah, no one's out here. Everyone's in the house. But yeah. So the book I was showing y'all, I may go back in the car, but it's pretty cool because I'm in the mouth, in the surface mouth. Be the head, not the tail. So I'm not in the tail, I'm in the mouth. So that's why you get the whole dragon. That's why another thing too, I like dragons. I like the whole aspect of the Kundalini being a dragon, the Nagas. Because I was looking at that like, wow, this really makes sense. It's like, whoa. Everything came together once I saw that. I'm like, okay, I'm in the dragon's mouth. So the whole, when you look at the whole Kundalini, I'm up here. That's why, you know, I'd be like, hey, I see purple. I'll be closing when I close my eyes and see purple. Or no, maybe gold a little bit. So, I don't know. I see purple a lot though. I'd be like, hey, it's Inanna or Isis or whatever you want to, name you want to use, you know. Yeah, and North Nod, that is the seeker, the truth. Now, I need to go back in my car and see what the South Nod is, but mainly, you know, the head still can't survive without the tail. It needs the tail. It needs those people who still at the bottom. And you need people that are at the top. And that's not the negative saying, because everything is all energy. So you got, like I said, you got positive and negative. And negative is just the inner going within. Positive is the outward. So being ahead, you're more a little bit outward in a way, because you're more outspoken. So you're more like hitting people left and right. That's why, you know, another thing too is when I be talking to people of water energy, right? Talking to people of water energy, they always seems like I'm saying something to make them feel as if I said something to hurt their feelings. Then I be telling them, hey, you get emotional. They get mad. Like I said something wrong, like, because you're emotional. Like, you being emotional. I'm just telling you that. Why am I being said I'm the bad guy? Because you're being emotional. I don't get it. So it's kind of like that. I'd be like, okay, you're just being emotional. So, but then again, anything I say that's a fire sign, people automatically take L's. You know, people take that as basically I'm pointing, because I'm a Sagittarius, of course, so I'm gonna say what I gotta say. And I'm just gonna let the shoot that arrow, right? So, it's what it is, really. That's how it is. And then being a dragon mouth, too, is my passion. Ooh, yes. I'm definitely gonna be shooting some arrows. That's awesome. Like I said, I like this book. The book is awesome. The book is awesome. People are outside, always shopping at Kroger's. People outside shopping at Kroger's. Alright. I don't know how long I can record this video, but I'm gonna let it keep running as long as I can. But yeah, the positive and negative basically is this right here. You got the yin and the yang. Like I said, it's nothing bad at all, really. You got what? Alright, so you got the positive signs, which is Aries and Sagittarius and Aquarius. Which is three positive signs for me. And my chart was showing that I have six qualities of the positive, of masculine. So, like, damn, I'm all masculine. Everything else, I got four in my chart that is negative, which is the feminine. Earth and water. So, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, yeah. And that's pretty much I do got, let me see, Venus. So, this whole thing with Venus. Yeah. So in a man chart, the position of Venus indicates what he is attracted to in a partner, the qualities he seeks, and what turns him on and what he desires, right? So I believe Venus was in my, let's take a look at the houses. Midhaven, signs, aspect, descent. So, I know, of course, Venus was in between Midhaven and my descent. So, it's over here. Like if you was looking at a clock, it's up here. Here we go. Scorpio, right? Sagittarius. Now, Venus is in my Sagittarius. That's the ninth house. According to this. So, Venus is, so basically saying that, you know, for me, as far as I go, the places of a woman I love is her hips and thighs. But, you know, I was like, you know, do I really need that to tell me I like hips and thighs? I don't think so. I like feet also, by the way. I don't know. I don't know where that feet stuff coming from. But I like feet too. I like everything about a woman. So hey, you know, I don't need the book to tell me I like this certain thing about a woman. I like everything about a woman. Feet, nails. Fingers. Yeah. That's the eighth house, right? Eighth house, what the eighth house talking about? In the eighth house, they got the snake biting its own tail. It's mortality and metaphysics. Transportation is the eighth house. Ninth house is philosophy, which I love philosophy. Masculine, fire. So, places your family is in university, publishing houses, newspaper, offices, foreign shores. Colors I like is green and white, which is true. I like green, like Ninja Turtles. Ever since I was a kid, Ninja Turtles. I like wearing green. Osiris, I got Osiris energy. As far as Egyptian zodiac goes, I have Osiris energy. So, and my key things are higher learning, philosophy, distance, horizon, ethics, vision, beliefs, religion, long journeys, and law. Keywords basically to find out who I am. That doesn't mean when you, so basically that's what it is, keywords to learn. So if you want to learn about, so basically seeking meaning, religion, or spirituality, you know, it's all part of the ninth house. So Venus being in the ninth house, which is something. So there's a lot of stuff I'm looking into. So Venus being in the ninth house, that means I gotta look into something else too, right? Because it just don't stop there. You gotta look at the planets are basically your personalities. Your houses is the overall aspect of, damn, what this said. Your overall, the overall aspects of you, who you are. I'm a Sagittarius, so. So, the bull, then you got the zodiac sign, the bull. Alright, so fix. So, neutral. It's fire. So, fire. So, then you gotta look at the elements. The fire signs, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, are characterized by a great appetite for experience, joyous approach to living. Fire is the element of creation, right? People born under the elements of fire have rapid thoughts, process, and acts of hunches. So I always go by my hunch. The fiery mind is intuitive, capable of plucking inspiration from ether. Yep, so that's why I'm always doing the whole six finger. That's why I'm always doing this, right? Light my switch, the ether button. So, yeah, but there's a lot of stuff I'm looking at in here. As far as Venus, love, Libra, Venus in let's see, so Venus through the signs. When Venus is in Sagittarius, desires companionship. Sociable, which is true. I am flirtatious. Lusty, it says, but you know, everyone got lust. Generous, but lusty is not bad. In the bad terms, it's basically you want. You got wants. Generous, independent, and promiscuous. Venus and Sagittarius fall rapidly in and out of love and seeks a courtesan, an entertaining companion, which is, will be nice. The hell, my courtesan? You know. I gotta go get my food now. It should be done. Let's see. It should be done. My food. Better go check it out. But yeah, get a courtesan. Like I said, usually my past life recordings and whatnot. The thing I do remember is being on Venus, being protective of the women. What you would call a eunuch, but not the type of thing where people think of today. Basically just a protector. Protector, that's basically what it was. But yeah. Alright, so I'm about to go check my food, make sure I have it real quick. I'm going to do a part two of this video, and I will catch y'all later. I'm about to eat. See ya. So this is Kachira signing off. Good to see y'all.